Shraddha, do stay with us. I'm being joined also by Vaibhav Agarwal of Angel Broking. Vaibhav, you know, the question to you really is, what does an investor who holds a PNB possibly do? But I want to first start by asking you to give us your initial commentary on the disastrous set of numbers we've picked up from PNB. The stock now is down 5.5%.
Exactly as you mentioned, the worst possible, outcome has actually happened. Of course, there was a lot of fear that of what kind of numbers, banks like PNB would give. But, with this kind of a huge and, completely exponential increase, in the gross and net NPAs, I think looking at any other item in the P&L becomes quite irrelevant. And net NPAs itself are now more than 50% of net worth. So clearly, there's a huge amount of provisioning that is, yet to be done in the coming quarters, and plus more pain to be recognized itself over the next few quarters. So, clearly, it does not look like, the fundamentals would improve anytime soon.
Okay, so I have a question. This is Shraddha here. What I'm trying to understand is, in your opinion, what has really led to this sharp provisioning number also? Do you expect that this could be led on account of that RBI stance to clean up balance sheets, or it could also be given the significant rise in NPAs, or even the fact that the bank could have been looking at increasing its provision coverage ratio, or all of these factors which would have really added to that kind of a provision number?
Clearly it's a mix of all these factors, and obviously in this quarter, because of the RBI requirements, their slippages, it seems, would have been way in excess of 10,000 crores plus, which would have been more than 3 to 4 times the run rate they've been doing in the last couple of quarters. And with that kind of huge quantum of NPAs, clearly any amount of provisioning would be insufficient. So even their coverage is obviously deteriorated quite a bit. But that has not been so. Even with this kind of provisioning, it's way below what they need to eventually provide. So clearly, their quarterly numbers are not enough to, absorb these kind of NPAs. And which is why the net NPAs have also gone up so drastically.
Sure, I want to bring Gaurang back into this conversation. Gaurang, I was asking you if you had a view on the PSU banking space, but I specifically want to ask you your view on PNB. What does someone who holds the stock do in a situation like this? Or do you think that with all the government's efforts and the RBI efforts to really clean up balance sheets, things could only get better going forward? This could probably be a very temporary blip.
I think the sectors which they are exposed themselves as far as the loan book is concerned need to revive. And if it is going to be metals or steel or anything else, I think it's going to be a long haul for them. It's even as a matter of fact for some of the priority sector lending. So my sense is that if you're invested, ask questions to the management as to where the money is gone and when do they expect the recovery to happen and what is it that they're going to do to make this number look a little bit better.
So, Shraddha here, what I want to understand is, what do you think could be the impact of the steel MIP that has been announced, given the fact that PNB exposure to the overall metal sector is significant at about 7 to 8%? Do you really think the iron and steel sector is really added to the stress for the quarter, or which are the key stress factors as far as Punjab National Bank is concerned?
Well, I think one of the factors could be the entire metal pack, because their loan book exposure is reasonably high, if I'm not mistaken. And that's where I think a large part of the strain has come in. I will only wait for the management to give out detailed commentary rather than assuming anything else.
Vaibhav, I want to understand from you specifically, started by asking you, what would you recommend to someone who holds this stock? And again, do you think this is something that's probably a temporary pain for the banking industry? Till 2017, they've been given time to clean up their balance sheets. So this could probably be temporary, and that you could start seeing a pickup as far as banking counters go. What's the recommendation for someone who holds a PNB?
Actually, almost all the PSU banks, and we continue to sort of, maintain that negative view.
Okay.
Simply because, even over a one year period of negative, that does not make sense to really hold the stock right now. And, the overall pain, considering that in overall, around the world itself, manufacturing is going through a very difficult time, commodities are going through a difficult time. It's very difficult to see a immediate solution to the problems of PSU banks, and with the kind of capital adequacy, et cetera, they really hamstrung to do anything. we would remain negative.
Vaibhav, you know, if you're looking at the NPA for an industry level over the past couple of quarters, in the previous quarter, it was at about 40%, and this is something that our research team has just put together. Provisioning for bad loans was up 62%. Now, given the kind of numbers that you're seeing from a PNB, it's obviously going to get worse, right? Where do you expect it to head from there?
Exactly. You know, I mean, clearly provisions, the banks need to make significantly large amount of provisions, you know, considering that net NPA is approaching 6%. I mean, that is the unprovided amount there itself. And like I was mentioning, that is now more than 50% of PNB's net worth. And, you know, with this kind of number, just to provide for the existing NPAs itself would take quite a bit of time. Plus, there would be more additional NPAs coming up in the next 1 year.
Vaibhav, if there was one question you could ask the management, they are expected to speak in just a short bit from now with the press. If there's one question that you want to understand from the PNB management, what would it be?
We would like to know the detailed, you know, sort of, you know, their explanation of, you know, the RBI, you know, the impact of the RBI requirements. How much has that contributed, and what is the expectation for 4Q from that same requirement and for even FY17, because, you know, apart from 150 accounts, there would be a larger universe as well, which is under stress. So clarity on that is, you know, critical. Certainty, some degree of certainty on that is very important for this stock to go anywhere from here.
All right, Vaibhav, thanks very much for speaking with us. That's PNB for you. It's down 4.5%. It's recovering just a little bit from the day's lowest point. Had crashed almost 5.5% after those numbers had come out. Just very quickly recapping the headline numbers that we have on PNB. You have, of course, missing the estimates. PAT is down about 93-odd%. You have a provisioning that's increased about 101%, and both our analysts are saying that there has to be clarity on why there's been the sharp increase in terms of provisioning. The rest of the details are also not looking good. Bad loans have increased. Gross as well as net NPAs have gone up for PNB. And do remember, this is the first of the big boys in terms of the banking space. So more clarity awaited on just where the pressure is being felt and whether this pressure is going to be across the board or whether this is something specific to PNB. Like Shraddha was saying, they have a large exposure to the steel industry as well. So whether this is particular to PNB or whether this is something we'll see across the board. The stock is down 4.5%, but there's much more coming up on the other side. We'll of course be connecting with the management of PNB, whole host of other earnings as well, including an ENL. Do stay tuned.